Hey everyone, welcome back to Homegrown Passion. In today's video, we're going to talk about the tomato plants, and then we're also going to talk about my nursery channel, how I'm rearranging the whole thing. So stay tuned. So I just got done taking care of the tomato plants, did some pollinating, and took off some of the bottom leaves. And I'm also taking off some of the smaller tomatoes on the clusters here, so I get bigger tomatoes. And I was watching Crop King's YouTube video that they just put up, I think it was last week, and Nathan Donnelly was going over all the different stages of tomato ripeness and when you should pick them off the tomato plants to really get your maximum production off of them. It was really informative. Put a link down below so you guys can watch it too. But that he was talking about getting the tomatoes off when they start having color on them and the different stars on the bottom of them and how you should pick them when they get a little bit of blushing and red on the bottom. Because this way then the tomatoes think they're done producing seeds and they won't do too much for the other fruit. So you want to get these off as soon as possible so you can keep the tomato plants in really good production. So what I learned from the video is it looks like these guys aren't quite ready yet for my type of production, because I do like to leave them on the vine a little bit longer to get the more sugars and more flavorful in there. But let me take you down farther and I'll show you one that I think is ready. So this one here, from what Nathan was saying, might be a little bit past their comfortable harvesting point. I mean, it's still fine to have it on the vine, but I'm going to go ahead and get this guy off of here. Let me go get my box and my clippers so I can get the tomatoes harvested off the plants here, and then we'll go over to the nursery channels. So Nathan talks about in the video about how to harvest these with your thumb and put it on the knuckle and pop it off. I'm not very good at that, so I always still use my clippers. Let me go ahead and get this guy off. So I'm really happy about getting these tomatoes off down low like this, because these guys are almost ready to lean and lower again. And if I do that, these guys will be sitting on the concrete and then they'll get dimples in them. So here are my nursery channels, and here's the pea shoots I harvested a few days ago. And I put them out here to get a little bit more green on them before I take them out to the chickens. Well, you can see I haven't taken them out yet, but I can't believe the growth on here. I guess maybe if you wanted to, you could probably get a second cutting off of these, but I think my ladies are really going to enjoy them. So these are the original nursery channels that came with the greenhouse package from Crop King, and they worked out really well for a while. But over the time, they started to leak here. They have a little bit different design setup. The 10-20 trays fit in here. You have your little dividers, but the water still would cascade over each one of these and go down there, because you would put your spaghetti tubes in here. But like I said, it's leaking, so I want to take this whole thing out and replace it with a new channel that I can put my 10-20 trays in, or I can grow microgreens in. And I think I talked about before that this LED light, when I was doing the microgreens, even though I had it turned down, I think to 40%, it was still way too intense because it's so close here that it was burning the plants, that once I turned it off, everybody perked right back up again. So I think I have another application for it up front here in the greenhouse, and I'm going to replace it with a fluorescent light. So I got the light unplugged over there, took the cord off. Let me take the driver off so it's a little bit lighter. Ooh, this thing is really heavy. And then I'll be able to take down the actual light unit. So I had to have a little help. Doug came out and helped me hang up the light here. It was a little too heavy and above my head to do it. And I was a little too wobbly on the ladder. So I'm not sure if it's in the right position. I'm not sure if it's too high, because it's a little bit higher than I normally had my other lights. But this being a brand new one, it could be a lot brighter. But if it does need to be lowered, I do have some room on the cable up there that we can untwist it there and lower it down as needed. So hopefully this is a good height and this light works really well. So I do have a timer back here that I used for the other light, and I do have it set to come on at the same time at 5 a.m. and go off at 9 p.m. as the other main grow lights there. So I'll go ahead and get this guy plugged in. And then there's a couple switches on the corner here. Yeah, I feel them right there, that turn on the both sets of lights. So I'm ready to use it. I can just get this guy turned on. So I have it all plugged in now. So let's turn this guy on and see what it does. Let's see. First switch does the two outside fluorescents. And then the next one does all the middle one. So looks pretty good. Since Doug was in here helping me with the light, I had him help me carry out the old one, and we just popped it right out and carried it out. And then I brought this one in and it slid right in. That's what's so nice about the Crop King components. They're all interchangeable and it just all fits together nicely. So I'm going to go ahead and get one of my 10-20 trays here from my other nursery channel and see how that looks. So here I have some Swiss chard. So let me bring this guy over. stick them here. Oh, look at that. Isn't that cool? And let me go ahead and get one of these plugged in here. I'm going to slide them down a little bit. I got the water here. I'm going to put the other ones on too, but let me slide them down underneath the lights here. Oh yeah, look how nice that is. Okay, I got my baby plants here in the nursery channel. Rearranged it a little bit to make sure everybody has optimal light. So I'm gonna watch it for a few days, see how everybody's growing. May even get my little light meter out here and see what's going on and make sure it has enough water. So far, just one emitter looks like it's gonna do the trick. And I'm also gonna keep this guy covered up a little bit here just to keep the algae at bay. So what's nice about these nursery channels is I can also grow the microgreens in here. The jute roll that I bought, it's 9.5 inches wide, which is this, and this channel is 8 foot long. So I can just put it here and take it down there and cut it at 8 feet and grow this whole thing in microgreens. And luckily I do have a few more of these channels because I do have a fodder system I have in storage that I did when I had the horses and sheep. So it's something I'm gonna get out here and maybe put in some of my empty spaces here in the greenhouse. And who knows, maybe I'll find some barley and do some fodder. So one more good thing about these wide trays is that the jute fits in here perfectly for my microgreen production because it's 9.5 inches wide and I have 2 100-foot rolls. Well, almost 200 foot rolls. I used a little bit, but I can just cut it out to 8 foot long here and I have a really nice growing space for it. I still have 1.5 rolls of the 3.5 inch Bio Strate that fits into the NFT channels, and I think they're like 50 feet long. So I'm going to use that up first before I start getting into the jute, but I think jute's going to be the way I'm going to go. Well, I hope you guys liked today's video, and if you want to have some fun, Saturday night, January 13th at 7 p.m., I'm going to do a live broadcast from in here in the greenhouse, so you can submit your questions, type them in, and I'll go ahead and answer them for you. So please tune in for that. And like always, please leave me questions, comments, and suggestions down below, and we'll see you guys next time.